scholars went?
You mean the village keepers? Oh, let me think. When I was eating dinner the other day, I saw one of them by the side of the road, muttering away and eating mushrooms and tree roots. They shouldn't go around eating that kind of stuff.
Okay. Did you notice anything else?
Anything else? No, I think that's all I have to tell you. Sorry.
The scholars that have gone missing. Have you seen them?
Those eyes. Those fierce eyes. You look like a real fighter.
Don't change the subject.
Right. You were asking about the mad scholars. I think it's been a few days since I last saw them. I usually go to bed pretty early, so I'm not too familiar with what goes on at night. But honestly, I feel quite sympathetic towards them. Even though they act a little strange, they've helped me in the past. If it weren't for them, my house would have collapsed long ago.
Do you also think Grandpa and the others are good people?
Grandpa? Oh, hello there. It's little Isak. You mean that nice man who looks like your grandpa's long-lost twin, right? He was actually the one who protected my house. I saw it with my own eyes. He happened to be staying near my house that day and was doing something with his hands on the ground. It still feels pretty surreal now that I think back on it. Did someone teach them how to do that? Well, whatever the case, I'll always be thankful to him and whoever taught him to look out for others. I'm pretty sure that if I ever went mad, I wouldn't be able to do anything like that.
Gotcha. Thank you. Recently? You know, the one who likes to sit and space out near the village entrance.
Oh, well, if it isn't Isak. Oh, your grandpa, huh? It's been a while. The last time I saw him, he was spacing out by the road as usual. I went and asked him if he'd like any of the food I had prepared, despite my wife's protests. Like many people, she's really quite terrified of them. And speaking of my wife, she's still always complaining about how I don't make enough mora. That might explain why she's always mad at me.
Oh, thank you. Thank you for taking care of him.
It was nothing. You're looking for him, right? Did he go for a walk and get lost?
Yeah.
Whew, that's no good. Well, once you found him, come by my place again, and I'll cook a little something for the both of you. I've known you since you were very young, so as far as I'm concerned, you're family. Please feel free to come by anytime.
Wow, what a nice guy!
Okay, thank you, sir.
Huh? Don't say anything for now. Isak, stay here. Let's head over there. Stay quiet as you move. Listen, see if you can make out what they're saying.
Have you heard? The mighty Scarlet King, the sovereign of our faith, will soon return to this world.
Yes, of course I have. The Scarlet King is the one and only true ruler of this land. I've never believed in any other gods. Still, you say he's coming back, but it sure doesn't feel like life's about to change around here anytime soon. What's your proof?
Haven't you noticed? The village has been getting more deranged scholars than ever. Delavar was saying that many people also went insane just before the fall of the Scarlet King's civilization in ancient times. We don't quite know why, but it seems like there's some sort of connection between insanity and the Scarlet King. Isn't it a sign of the Scarlet King's power that all the mad scholars have disappeared? If you ask me, they must have been chosen as the final sacrifice for the Scarlet King's resurrection.
Huh. Now that you say it, that does make some sense. Does this mean our lives are finally going to take a turn for the better?
Exactly. Those city folks will get what's coming to them.
Now, repeat everything you've just said from the very beginning.
Huh?
Who are you? Where did you come from?
My patience is running thin. You heard what I asked.
Yeah, bro, this guy's something else. Just look at his eyes. One wrong move, and he's gonna flay us alive.
Let's not get on his bad side, okay? I am no match for this guy.
Okay, good sir. What is it you would like to know?
Tell me about the Scarlet King's resurrection.
Well, I only know a few things from hearsay. I went for a drink the other day and heard others talking about a rumor that the madmen will disappear and that the Scarlet King will return to this land. I'm not making this up, I swear!
Hey, go on, keep talking.
It's true. It's all true, sir. We desert folk have had more than enough of those people at the academia. They keep sending us all their mad scholars and won't let us have a good life. Would you want to live like this if you were in our place? The radicals were even more thrilled than me when they heard the news. We're all praying for the Scarlet King's speedy return. Delavar also said that once the Scarlet King returns to our side, it's only a matter of time before we conquer the land on the other side of the wall. They're all willing to serve under the Scarlet King and fight for a share of the glory.
Is that so?
Seems like he still wants to know more. Keep talking.
Got it. At first, I told myself it was just the drink talking. But then all the mad scholars vanished without a trace, just as the rumor said. Please don't beat me up just for mentioning these rumors. If I'm guilty, then everyone else around here is also guilty. I'm just saying what the others said.
The people here really like the Scarlet King, but dislike the Dendro Archon.
Where is this radical person you talked about?
I haven't run into him over the past few days, so he probably hasn't been around the village. What about you, man? Have you seen him at all?
No, not at all. We wouldn't dare lie to you. He's really not here right now.
Sounds like you're not too close with the radicals.
No, of course not. All we know are their names.
I have many ways to stop you from talking. And many others to stop you from sending warning messages. So you'd best just stay home and hope I don't hear of you trying to contact anybody. Don't do anything until I've gotten to the bottom of this. Try something foolish, and even Candace won't be able to protect you.
Yes, got it. We'll do just as you say.
That scared Paimon half to death. Sino is pretty terrifying. He didn't try to reassure us at all. It's like he's used to hearing that. Oh, Paimon bets lots of people have told him that before.
I heard that.
Sorry.
It's part of being a Matra. The rumor we heard just now seems like a strong lead. But we need to check a few more places. Very well.
Isaac!
I'm here!
Where's your grandpa's house?
Well, I can take you there. Just follow me! Grandpa, he likes to be alone. Sometimes he stares at the sky in a daze, and other times he just pokes at the ground with his fingers. Every now and then, he yells out at the top of his lungs, so a lot of people are really scared of him. But he's a good person, really. I know he is. I swear, he's just like my real grandpa. Where Grandpa usually stays.
There sure isn't much here.
No.
Incense? Please don't say it's the same one as book, but are you okay? Are you getting dizzy or need to lie down?
There's a scent that you can sense, but I can't.
A certain traveler here once passed out from that smell. Thankfully, Tainari saved the day. And then he gave us a long lecture to explain all about how it worked.
So, you know Tainari?
Huh? You know him too? Are you two friends?
Yes. Now that I concentrate, I can also make out the scent of incense.
Wait, surely Tainari didn't lecture you too?
No, no need. Did you first encounter this scent at Tainari's house? In the forest. From a scholar. Here it is. Take a look right here.
Paimon doesn't see anything.
Although the traces have been completely buried in the sand, there are footprints here. From the size and shape, they belong to an adult male. This pattern is a common one from this area. Local shoot, the scent is quite faint. But still—
But who would come looking for Grandpa? He doesn't have any friends.
We'd have to ask whoever lured him away with the incense.
Huh? So you can lure someone away with just a scent? Hey! What's wrong with liking good food? Everyone's got something they love in life!
Exactly. Most scholars are fond of incense, since the smell supposedly helps them clear their minds and discover new knowledge. Even deep within the clutches of madness, they still yearn for their knowledge-seeking days, and will follow the scent whenever it presents itself.
No, Grandpa.
So, someone's taking advantage of their weakness? Huh. Still, why would anyone want to abduct all the scholars? Are the rumors really true? Could the disappearance of all the mad scholars have something to do with the radicals?
It's highly likely.
Please, you have to save my grandpa. Grandpa's never done anything wrong. Please help him.
Sounds like we'd better help get him back. Don't you worry, Isak. We won't let whoever took him get away with it.
Let's head to Aru Village and inform Candace and the others about what we learned here. After that, we'll set off to find the scholars.
Right. The darker fabric definitely looks a lot better. That'd be my choice, too.
We're back, Candace! We've got a lot to tell you!
Ah, welcome back.
Sounds like everyone's friends already.
Oh, Dia's here too!
You bet. So, everything goes smoothly?
Reasonably.
Ahatham didn't go with you?
We haven't seen him at all.
Huh. I saw him around the village entrance earlier and figured he was investigating with you. I guess he must have gone off on his own.
Did you find out anything useful? I see. So someone used a kind of incense to lead the exiled scholars away from the village.
The resurrection of the Scarlet King? First I've heard of it. Far as I know, the kind of incense you just mentioned is only popular beyond the wall. Scholars are fond of it, but as you can see, there aren't many scholars still studying around these parts. No seller would be able to make a profit here. Not to mention, making incense is a labor-intensive process. You won't see anybody in the desert with the patience to make or sell something that requires that kind of effort. It seems someone from beyond the wall must have been supporting this.
Makes sense.
So what should we do then? Do we go back to the academia and search for leads there?
If it was any other day, that would be your next logical step. But today, you've got me on your team, so you get an extra tip. Didn't you say that the villager got his news from the tavern? Well, I also like to drink at the tavern, so I know a thing or two about these radicals he mentioned.
If Paimon remembers correctly, the leader of the radicals is some guy called Delavar.
Ah, yeah. Delavar, the scar-riddled bandit, Engur, the wide-eyed butcher, and Jabari, the ducktail bearded crook. The whole lot of them are known around these parts. These guys have one thing in common, and that's being broke. The rougher life gets, the more they want to believe in the Scarlet King. Way they see it, the Scarlet King's resurrection is their only chance at overthrowing the academia. Throwing all of Sumeru into chaos is the only way to change the way of life here in the desert. Anyway, that's my guess why they've chosen to become radicals.
Tia! You're amazing! You really know this place inside and out!
No merc can afford to slack off on gathering intelligence. Every mora I've spent in the tavern has been a valuable investment.
Let's head out.
Now hold on, you're staying right here, Sino.
Why?
Aru Village is not a big place. Outsiders stand out here like a sore thumb. I'd bet word about you has already gotten out. The desert is unforgiving, so the way of life here is also a lot tougher than on the outside of the wall. You survive on making connections out here. Compared to you, mercs like me are just third-rate amateurs. I've got no actual fighting skills to speak of. But that also makes it a whole lot easier for me to gain the locals' trust. I need to go around and ask some questions, but it'll be difficult if you're with me.
Fine.
Good. Then we've got a plan. The Traveler and Paimon will go to Caravan Rebot with me, and we'll try our best to figure out where the Mad Scholars have been taken. Sino, you'll have to stay in the village and continue investigating on your own.
All right! Sounds like a plan!
Sounds like you're starting to get familiar with the area.
Paimon's amazed every time we see the Wall of Samiel. How can a wall this tall even exist?
I know what you mean. I had the same question every time I walked this way when I was a kid. Also, why is this high wall here? And can a wall really block sandstorms? It was only after I grew up that I realized the Wall of Samiel isn't just there to keep out the sandstorms. It serves a more important purpose. Sumeru is run by wise and mighty sages. To them, us desert dwellers are nothing but tools that can be used and discarded at their whim. We're cheap labor, like livestock, but easier to control. Nothing more. Even if a child from the desert got the chance to obtain an Akasha terminal, almost all their requests for knowledge would be denied. The academia believes we're underserving. Geniuses like Sitaria are one in a million. The other children never get a single chance to try and rewrite their fate, even though the academia knows very well that we're humans, just as they are.
That's terrible.
I would tear down this wall with my own hands if I could. No, not at all. This place just gets me thinking, that's all. Besides, we're here to procure information, aren't we?
Yep! We gotta catch those!
Shh! Caravan Rebot is crawling with people, so be careful what you say. We don't want anyone to find out what we're here for. Our mission started the moment we arrived here. Let's go check out the tavern. Maybe we'll find someone I know. Just our luck. None of them are here today.
You mean, you don't see anyone you know?
Dia, is that you? What a coincidence. You here for a drink too?
Zaki? Finally, a friendly face.
Oh, and who do you have with you here? Guests from another land? Hello, hello. I'm Zaki. Dia's, how would you put it? Drinking buddy?
We've had drinks together a few times. You could say we go back a ways. Anyway, as far as my friends here, they aren't too shabby, are they? You rarely see any Outlander so friendly and respectful nowadays.
Absolutely. Much better than those people on the other side of the wall. So, Dia, are you looking for someone?
Yeah. Have you seen Engur, Delavar, or Jabari recently?
Of course I have. Matter of fact, we were all here drinking together just a few days ago.
I've got a spice trading deal from another nation. I thought maybe Delavar and his friends might be interested. Know where I could find him?
Ah, how thoughtful of you. Then I assume you also know that Delavar's been having a hard time making ends meet these days, so you came here to help him out?
Hey, keep it down. Let's just say I prefer to keep this deal a secret. Y'all at Caravan Rebot are like family. If there's more to be made, why not do it together? Besides, Delavar and his friends have muscle. They'd be a good fit for escorting the goods.
Yes, how considerate of you. Delavar's my friend too, so of course I can take you to him. Come with me.
Ugh!
there yet?
Yep, this is the place.
This place is practically deserted. What are they doing in a place like this?
Why don't you take a guess? Go on, a wild stab in the dark.
What's this all about, Zaki?
Come on, Dia. You really think we didn't hear about what you said back in Aru Village? The boys have kept a close eye on you from the moment you set foot there. Not only do I know that you're looking for Delavar, I also know that you've teamed up with people from the Academia to look for the missing scholars.
So, you've been watching us from the very beginning?
Uh-oh. Paimon knew leaving Sino behind was a mistake!
And you left the strongest one in the village, didn't you? Who do you think you are? You really thought we'd fall for your little business deal nonsense?
So you and Delavar have been partners all along.
Dia, I guess it's only natural for a traveling mercenary like you to be out of the loop. Those of us who hang around the tavern have stronger bonds than you think. But you got one thing right. We're all looking forward to an uprising in Sumeru. There's nothing more we'd like to see than the desert folk overthrowing the Academia.
If that's the case, then I'm sure Delavar wouldn't miss a second of it.
I'll be honest with you. If it weren't for what you said in the village, your little monologue about the Wall of Samiel would have convinced me that you're one of us.
Delavar. And Engur, you're here too, huh?
Long time no see, Miss Mercenary. You should have known the traitors are what us followers of the Scarlet King despise the most.
Dia, I thought that you, a fellow desert dweller, would understand that the Scarlet King is greater than the Dendro Archon. Little did I know, you don't deserve to join us.
Yeah, gee, what a missed opportunity. Adopting radical views and kidnapping innocent scholars, all because of some baseless rumors. Anything else I'm missing out on?
See? There you have it. Mercenaries are just a bunch of faithless scum with only one thing on their minds. Mora. Pathetic. You're all like a pack of street rats.
You're not wrong. Mercenaries are driven by Mora, and my faith lies with whoever's paying me. As long as there's a profit to be made, anyone can become my friend.
Enough talking! Get him!
Just as I expected. Let's teach him a lesson, traveler.
Following orders.
Stabilize.
I will have order.
Shine down.
Born of ice and fire.
Let's dance. Go for
it.
Impossible! How could you?
So, what do you think about your meticulous network now, Zaki? How did you say it? It's only natural for a traveling mercenary like me to be out of the loop. I'm guessing your informant told you that I'm just an incompetent merc with no real fighting skills, correct? I mean, that is what I said after all. And of course, you would believe everything he reported. The only thing you know about me is that I'm a mercenary, but you've never seen me in action. Even though you heard we went to handle monsters together, you believed that Candace was the only one doing all the real fighting. That so-called Flame Mane is just a fraud. She admitted it herself. She just uses her connections to gain the trust of others. That's what you thought, right?
Ugh. You lied in the village because you figured that we'd have people watching you.
And you were stupid enough to fall for it. I figured as much the first time we drank together. You all thought you were so smart. Pathetic. Okay, that should be all of them.
Whoa! So you've been planning this since we were in Aru Village?
No task can be done without preparation. I just happened to notice a couple suspicious-looking people while you were out investigating.
Oh, but instead of catching them right away, you let them report back.
Those two who were snooping around were just a couple small fries. If we want to get the real catch, we have to be patient and give it some time.
Oh, you mean the funny name she mentioned back in Uncle Ampu's house? The Wide-Eyed Butcher, Scarbottle Bandit, Paimon can't remember them all.
That's just a bunch of drunk talk. Engar and Delavar like to talk themselves up when they're drinking. Engar the Wide-Eyed Butcher and Delavar the Scar-Riddled Bandit are the nicknames they came up with for themselves. Alcohol has a way of making people share what they really think, so Engar and Delavar are always rambling in the tavern about how the Scarlet King is a superior deity.
What about Zaki?
He's just a numbskull who fell right into our trap. Zaki was probably the best hidden of them all. My initial plan was to find Delavar first, and then try to track him down. That's what you wanted to ask when we were at Uncle Anpu's house, right? Jabari is one of the villagers you talked to. You know, the one who wanted to treat Isak and his grandpa to some food.
Wait, so he's a radical too?
No, he isn't. I just needed to tack on a random villager name to make the eavesdropper think that I was making some wild guesses based on my impressions.
Wow! What a genius idea! Well, that's an expert mercenary for ya!
Ah, you're too kind. It was straight from the usual playbook, if I'm honest.
So, that thing you were saying before, is it really true?
Hmm? About what?
About how mercenaries only care about Mora, and that anyone's a friend as long as there's a profit.
Does that bother you? What makes you so sure?
Dia, do you dislike the Dendro Archon like the other desert folk?
You two are pretty sharp. No, I don't have anything against the Dendro Archon. I've heard a lot of nice things about the Lesser Lord from Dunyarzad. I can understand her devotion and gratitude. Dunyarzad's just an ordinary person. There's no way a god would be so involved in the lives of everyday people, unless they were truly compassionate. I've begun to realize that the sages are behind everything that's happened recently. The radicals' blind belief in the Scarlet King, making the Dendro Archon out to be an enemy. It's all the academia's trickery. But I see through it all. And unlike them, I can never be hostile towards anyone who's never done anything wrong.
Dia.
Anyway, looks like we're done with business here. Traveler, lend me a hand. Let's tie him up and bring him to the village. This should be all of them. I'll let you take it from here.
All right. I'll be in touch. Until then, please stand by.
Candace, do you need any help?
Candace will be okay on her own. I trust her, so you can too. She's been guarding Aru Village for quite some time now. If anyone is qualified to question the offenders, it's her.
While I'm questioning them, why don't you pass some time by exploring the area?
I'll meet you back here tomorrow morning, Traveler. As for these idiots, let's just hope they live to see another day.
Hey, Dia!
Right on time. We'll know any moment now.
Paimon's been wondering. You seem to know Candace pretty well. Have you been friends for a long time?
We've known each other for some time now. She's a pretty interesting person. Even though she's an extremely strong warrior, she never misuses her powers against others.
Oh, Paimon knows what you mean. Like a lot of martial artists say, never take the fight outside the ring.
Yep, I guess you can put it that way. It takes strong convictions to be as dedicated as she is, and shoulder that kind of responsibility. Us mercs, on the other hand, we pretty much live from one day to the next.
Well, Paimon thinks you're great, too.
Really? Thanks for that.
Oh, Zaino's here, and he's pretty early, too.
Yes. I was here yesterday to help out a little.
To help out? By doing what?
Sharing some interrogation techniques.
Oh! You mean you taught Candace some more persuasive methods?
Right.
Come on in, everyone.
Come on, let's go inside.
Do I? What gave it away?
Oh, there's no mask that can hide true bloodlust. Cover up your eyes, and it'll still show itself at the corners of your mouth.
Perhaps I need to work on my composure. Still, it's perfectly understandable why I'm angry. I'm sure everyone present would agree.
Yes, ma'am.
Please, don't beat us anymore. We're gonna die.
Well, looks like Zaino taught her well.
You fear death yourselves, yet you do not hesitate to place the lives of others at risk. The absurdity is mind-boggling. The ones you call mad scholars are known to us as the Village Keepers. They are vital members of our community, and some even count them as family. You come here, to my village, and you treat my people as nothing more than stepping stones towards your goal. Tell me, what would you do to you in my position?
Mercy! Please have mercy!
You've made your bed.
We may both be desert dwellers, but there is one thing that I understand better than you. The resurrection of the Scarlet King will only result in war. And war serves no one. The people of Aru Village care little about which god is in power. Life may be tough and tiring, but we wish to preserve our way of life. A war would only cause us to lose all that we have. And that is not a responsibility that you can afford to shoulder.
We understand. We're sorry! I'll tell you everything I know, please, just... let us go.
I'm listening.
You might not believe this, but it wasn't us who came up with this idea. Someone was spreading rumors in the tavern. That's how we ended up hearing about the Scarlet King's resurrection. Some mystery man told us that mad scholars will make the perfect sacrifice to usher in the Scarlet King's resurrection. They give their lives, and we can get anything we wish for.
They're called Village Keepers. Slip up again, and you'll regret it.
Yes, sorry! It was all that mystery man's doing. He told us to spread word about the Scarlet King's resurrection, and talked us into helping him. In return, he said he'll help facilitate the resurrection process. I'm not sure.
That's one.
Huh? One what?
Strike. You get a total of three. Then, you die by my hand.
Wait, I'm telling the truth! We don't know anything! It was all him!
Two.
He got us to lure them out of their houses in the night with some kind of incense. We take them to a junction outside the village, then the mystery guy takes them from there! You gotta believe me, please. I'm telling the truth, I swear. Just ask them if you don't believe me!
That was indeed the truth. Traveler, go on.
You have to believe me. If I knew that, I would have told you his name right away. I'm not risking another beating to keep his secrets. No way! That guy, he wears a cloak, and he's always careful to cover his face. He calls himself the Scarlet King's envoy.
I believe I may know what's going on.
Uncle Anpu? What do you mean? Smooth.
Okay, speak.
If my suspicions are correct, this mystery man they speak of could be from the Academia. Some time ago, people from the Academia attempted to take the village keepers away. I refused, insisting that they are part of our community. It strikes me now that this secretive character shares the same goal they had.
Which means it's highly likely that the Academia was purposely spreading a false rumor to trick the radicals into delivering the village keepers right into their hands. They were the ones who brought them here to begin with. Now they're trying to take them back? We aren't gonna let that happen.
Not the Academia again.
Just as I thought. But what could they want with the village keepers?
People are nothing but tools in the eyes of the Academia. A change in their plans likely means they found another way to exploit the scholars. Regardless, our top priority now is locating the village keepers.
You're right. Isak is still waiting for news on his grandpa.
Time to go. Let's leave the village and try to track them down.
Yes. Pack up and get ready to leave.
You got it. Candace, I'll let you deal with the radicals. Leave everything outside the village to us.
All right.
Let's meet back here once everyone's ready.
Yeah.